during his earthly crown wore no crown except a crown of thorns. The Pope is waited on by servants. What a contrast to the lowly Nazarene who came not to be ministered to, but to minister. Now, the immorality of many popes, especially in the past century, stands in sharp contrast to Christ, who in perfect inholiness and purity showed the real way of being a servant. Now, when turning to the book of Revelation in the Catholic Bible also, we find in Revelation 13, verses 18, here is wisdom. He who has understanding, let him calculate the number of the beast, for the number is the number of a man, and its number is 666. That is the mark of a man, the mark of the beast. Now, in view of these things, we believe that the claim that the Pope is the vicar of Christ is without any basis in fact. Now, in examining the Morse code, every letter has a number. When translating into Latin, which was the prominent language of the Roman Catholic Church, Vicar of Christ, in Latin, Vicar of Christ adds up to 666. Now, it should be pointed out, although in all fairness, that various names and titles, depending on how they are written and in different language, produce this number. Now, the examples given here are of special interest because they are linked with Rome, the old Roman Empire, and Roman Catholicism. The very Roman Empire of olden days is nothing but Rome today, and the Roman Empire had only six numbers. Now examine this. D, C, L, X all add up to 666. Now it was Nero who was one of the greatest Christian persecutors of the day. His name, written in Hebrew, it adds up to 666. The Greek letters for the word Latinos, or Latin, which was the historical language of Rome and the Church, adds up to 666. Now, turning to the Bible itself in the Old Testament, we read that King Solomon each year received 666 talents of gold. Now, this wealth played an important part in leading him astray. In the New Testament, the letters for the Greek word euphoria, for which the word wealth is translated, total of 666. Out of the 2,000 Greek nouns in the New Testament, there's only one other word, paradosia, and it also translated as tradition, adds up to 666. Wealth and tradition, interestingly enough, were the two great corruptors of the Romish Church. Wealth corrupted in practice and honesty, and traditions corrupted in doctrine.
But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, and in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I will be with you always, to the very end of the age." I am sending you to open their eyes and turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan to God, so that they may receive forgiveness of sins and a place among those who are sanctified by faith in me. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.